What has science taught us about sexual orientation? What we know about it is limited because it's hard to recruit participants into studies. There is a social stigma, so if you post a study about sexual orientation, those who feel that they meet the criteria may not volunteer. In studies of sexual behavior, we have some estimates about same-sex behavior versus opposite sex behavior. About 8% of the population will report to having engaged in same-sex relations, and 11% report having same-sex attraction. Interestingly, about 1% of the population reports having no sexual interest at all, or falling into the category of asexual. So, we do not understand why individuals end up with different types of sexual orientations. Early studies have ruled out the idea that it's solely determined by environmental causes, such as upbringing, how you were raised, things that have happened to you in life. Evidence is mounting that it's a combination of genetic and epigenetic influences on the person. When you look across the animal kingdom, a variety of sexual orientation behavior can also be observed. Recent research with humans have found that within the hypothalamus itself, there are two regions which vary in size across individuals with different orientations. If you're interested in learning more about this topic, there is a wonderful book by Simon LeVay called Gay, Straight, and the Reason Why: The Science of Sexual Orientation. This book is highly readable, and it details all of the studies that have looked at the brain research, the genetic research, information about prenatal pregnancy environment, and he sums up what we know and what we don't know on this interesting topic. That's all for now.